Welcome to the NBA's Dazzling Dunks and Basketball Bloopers. I'm Marv Albert.
And I'm Dick Clark.
An early indication that this may well be the longest 45 minutes of my life.
Are you kidding, Marv? This is going to be great. I love these blooper tapes. Guy's getting hit in the head with the ball. We're going to show that, right?
Well, I believe there will be a few of those shots, yes.
And guys running into the stands? I love it. I think we should show guys losing the ball. That would be the greatest. You know, when guys just keep losing the ball over and over again, I think we should really show that.
Frank, has anyone ever suggested that you should switch to perhaps decaffeinated coffee?
I should also break it to you that we're going to show some broadcasting blunders also.
Well, that's all right, because I caught a sneak preview earlier, and I think you'll be equally amused by some of the more memorable coaching antics.
What's so funny about coaches? I think we should save the time for guys missing shots. You know, when, hey, all right, what's going on? I was having a great time.
Hey, enough of the previews, Frank. Let's just get to the first set of bloopers.
All right, are we going to watch the guys falling in the stands?
Just roll the clips.
This is my favorite part.
They're basketball's finest, the pros of the NBA, and they are undoubtedly among the world's greatest athletes. Over the last several years, we've captured on tape some of the more memorable events of these athletes in their quest for perfection. It is truly amazing what these athletes can do. For a round object, the basketball takes some strange bounces. The ball may move swiftly, but the trained eye of the pro always keeps it in sight. Once the art of ball handling is mastered, scoring is the name of the game, and nobody can top the pros at it. Maintaining possession of the elusive sphere is to the pro's advantage, a skill he has spent years perfecting. Basketball at its finest. Poetry in motion.
That's just some of what you'll be seeing as the colorful former coach and now president of the Utah Jazz, Frank Layden, and I take a look at the lighter side of the NBA.
You know what I love even more than the bloopers, Marv?
Let me take a wild guess. Would it be the all-you-can-eat buffet at Denny's?
Of course, but I also love the slam dunk.
Well, a silky segue from Layden. And coming up next, we'll take a look at some of the best slam dunks we've ever seen in the NBA.
Showtime!
Look out for the women and children. Oh, no.
Oh!
who's your favorite all-time coach?
All-time coach, I'd have to say, Billy Martin.
The Bear.
The Bear, who's the Bear?
The Bear is the football coach.
Vince Lombardi.
Vince Lombardi?
Your favorite Wettigan?
Yeah.
Probably, I used to like Bill Russell.
Bill Russell, all right.
Glasnuts.
You're the Glasnuts,
yeah,
the famous Glasnuts. Soccer team.
Yeah.
Willis Reed.
You never heard of Frank Layden?
No.
You never heard of Frank Layden? You've never seen Frank Layden?
Thanks a lot.
Frank, it must be awfully difficult for you to go out into public with all the mobs of fans that recognize you.
Marv, it's the price of fame. There's certain people in this world, you know, Paul Newman, Robert Redford. We simply cannot go out into public without being attacked by the fans. But that's what I get for being such a popular coach. I can't help it.
Well, speaking of coaching, and there's a Frank Layden transition for you, let's spend a few moments and admire those cool, level-headed field marshals as they calmly direct their troops in battle.
Tonight we're having linguine with marinara sauce tonight.
Watching the game.
We have a chicken cutlet that we're going to put a little sauce on top of the chicken cutlet.
Get in the game now.
One more time, we heat. One more time.
Not in the game.
Can I have a drink of water? Okay, I taste it first. Do I taste it? Yeah. How do I know somebody didn't put something in it?
No! Hey, Chip, if you missed it, admit it, will you?
After watching those clips, is there any chance you might return to courtside?
Of course. As president of the Jazz, I get 2 courtside tickets to every home game.
Sounds like a good deal.
It's a great deal. I love it. But you know what I love even more? Some more slam dunks.
What a coincidence you should say that, because coming up next, we have more slam dunks.
Now, this is my favorite part coming up.
Dunk. The sports world's perfect harmony of power and grace. For a brief moment, it even confirms man's ancient desire for flight. It is a shot which strikes a delicate balance between instincts and artistic creativity. And in the hands of the NBA's most athletic players, nothing else can captivate our imagination quite like the slam dunk.
Basketball. 5 men on a side in 40 minutes of strenuous competition. But let's get the lowdown on the fine points of this game. The trick backhand pass. It's deceptive, fancy, but safe only for experts. Dribbling the ball is used as a substitute for passing. Boy, there's form. In conclusion, if you want to win games without too much effort, just grow up and do this. It's not legal, but it simplifies things.
Hey, Marv, how about you and me shaking it up a little? I'm sure the nation would love to see Marv Albert dance.
This must be the moment where I wake up and say, that was the strangest nightmare I've ever had.
Seriously, Marv, how many times in your life have you danced?
Including my wedding?
Yeah.
None.
Gee, what a surprise.
What a stinking comeback by Layden, right on target.
No, really. They don't dance like they used to, and they don't dribble like they used to either.
Uh-oh, I smell Segway.
I'm just making a simple statement. Today's guy simply can't dribble, and I have the clips to prove it.
I was right.
This is my favorite one. You know, Marv, I just realized something. The fact that those guys can't dribble anymore doesn't even matter.
Why is that?
Why? Because the ball doesn't even touch the floor anymore in the NBA. Watch this.
You're getting awfully good at this, Frank.
This time I really mean it. This is my favorite part. Oh.
Watching those clips, it's clear that the NBA players are among the world's finest athletes. And as we will soon see, their athletic versatility extends beyond the game of basketball. In fact, we have gone as far as to conduct our own Olympic Games with the results almost as amusing as the antics of Mr. Layden.
Really?
Over the years, Red Auerbach's torch has become a symbol that says, let the games begin. Who could forget Mary Lou Retton opening the 84 games in L.A.? Alvin Robertson shattered the record in the long jump, a mark that still stands. Roy Hinson has proven over the years to be the most consistent triple jumper. And in synchronized jumping, named one team that won more gold medals than Golden State. In freestyle wrestling, Reggie Theus has the record for the quickest pin. While in Greco-Roman style, the captain has sailed away with four gold medals over the years. In judo, James Bailey has kicked out all competition. And when one thinks of the javelin, Jeff Rulin is usually the first name that comes to mind. In the dash, no one ever got out quicker than the doctor. Gerald Henderson holds more hurdling records than any other player. Team handball has always been dominated by the Lakers. At least, it seems that way. In the equestrian, Mike McGee rode off with the honors. But no player has dominated an event like Frank Johnson. Every year, the competition tries new routines, but the numbers always favor Johnson. The game certainly managed to preserve the spirit of friendly competition. and the closing ceremonies are a fitting tribute. As the torch of athletic perfection burns brightly.
Who's your favorite coach, though, in the NBA?
Frank Mattin.
Who's your favorite coach in the National Basketball Association?
Rick Pitino. Riley of the Lakers.
Riley, good Irishman, right, like us?
Yeah.
Huh? You like your job, by the way? Do you know any of the coaches in the NBA at all? Can you think of even one off the top of your head?
No, tell you the truth.
No.
Next, are you familiar with a coach by the name of Frank Layden?
No.
You never heard of him?
No.
Used to coach Utah?
No.
You know where Utah is?
Yes.
Dazzling Dunks and Basketball Bloopers presents You Fake the Call. Boston Celtic forward Kevin McHale, on his way to the basket, barrels over Detroit Piston John Sally. Is this a violation? You fake the call. Since McHale is a perennial all-star, playing at home in Boston Garden, there is no violation. This is a legal play.
You know, Frank, many fans are confused about the illegal defense rule. Who better to explain it than you, a former legendary NBA coach?
Well, Marv, it's really very simple. There's two types of illegal defenses. There's the illegal defense, and there's the truly illegal defense. Now, the first one, the illegal defense, I'm not really that sure about. The second illegal defense is much easier to understand. In fact, I've strung together a few examples, and it just so happens that this is my favorite part of the tape.
In wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone. I want to be a
I think now's a fitting time to pay tribute to a man many consider to be the most important in all of basketball, a man without whom the sport of basketball may not even be possible. I'm talking, of course, about the referee.
And you here? No.
What the hell do you want? Well, tell him to shut up.
I said shut up!
Get the hands down!
Don't give me that crap! I don't need your help, Manny! Why don't you play the game and stop crying, you big baby?
One plus one.
Two!
Number three!
Number four! 33.
Who's a foul on?
33.
Foul's on Bird.
Bingo!
You got caught with your hands in a cookie jar by stepping in.
Tell you what, steak dinner.
No.
Steak dinner.
No.
Steak dinner.
No.
Steak dinner.
Okay, that's good.
When the referees aren't around to police the action, there's one group of men willing to accept the challenge. And with the riffraff, screaming, and guys with paper bags on their heads, you need more than police. You need SWAT!
And now here's Frank Layden with his favorite play.
This never fails. The secret to the play is balance. Marv, you want those guards being able to move in and out and across. Inside, we want that forward on the left-hand side, sometimes called the weak side, to be moving up and down and making himself very hard to stay with. In the meantime, the center will go from corner to corner. He will go from pocket to pocket, box to box, maintaining his poise in the middle of the floor. On the opposite side, sometimes called the strong side for some of you broadcasters, we would have the forward, again, trying to be free by going up, changing direction, changing his pace, moving quickly from the outside to the inside. Marv, it's very simple, but very effective. And by the way, hi, Mom.
Frank Layden redefining the NBA chalkboard, not to mention comedy itself.
You want comedy? I got the greatest joke. Can I tell it now?
Quickly, Frank. Come on. We're...
Well, you see, there was this farmer. He had three daughters, and a guy comes knocking at the door.
Frank, let's get back to the clips. You know, there's nothing quite like a good basketball announcer deftly describing the action with color and with accuracy. Now, it's a wonder that these men can rise to such a difficult challenge game after game with flawless performances, never showing a seam.
I love this part.
Set themselves up with 31 victories against only 8 losses as they would head for Sacramento, and that would be a...
Never fails.
He has a baseball assignment with the Indians in Arizona tomorrow. And we'd like to thank that gentleman very much for walking right through our shot.
Well represented. We've got that.
Good gracious. Could she set a pick?
Look for me.
Is similar to the kinds of responses that...
Scoring record for the Portland Trail Blazers was 9,702. Let me look.
Oh, so in other words, you're asking us to trust you?
I think you've changed. I think you've mellowed. I think you've become a better guy, don't you?
Rodney McRae, the great years of Houston. Jerry Reynolds, great years in, well, in his dreams so far.
And he's in second place now in the assist department.
That ball hit me right in the head.
Is that a Larry Bird fan or a Rory Sparrow fan?
Before he made his move. Oh,
same to you, kid.
Up to this point, we have omitted what many people feel is the greatest thing to watch in the NBA. No, we're not talking about the Laker girls. I'm talking, of course, about the annual slam dunk competition.
You know, Marv, the history behind the slam dunk? It's very interesting. Most people don't know who invented it or where it started. The slam dunk competition was invented by none other than Julius Caesar. Small guy, great leaper, they called him Dr. C. In the year 73 BC, believe it or not, he signed a law preventing...
Frank, you have no idea who invented the slam dunk, do you?
None at all. I just wanted some more airtime.
All right. Now, here is the history of the slam dunk competition. Anything to add, Mr. Layden?
Have I mentioned that this is my favorite part?
The man actually responsible for elevating the slam dunk from a high percentage shot to an art form was Julius Irving, alias Dr. J. The doctor was joined by a young group of ABA Skywalkers in the first slam dunk contest, where he was officially crowned the slam dunk king.
And that sends everyone reeling. Julius Irving.
After entering the NBA, Irving inspired a new legion of dunkers, including his new teammate, Darryl Dawkins, who took dunking from the sublime to the ridiculous.
I had to get out of the way and backboard swing. If you ain't grooving, you best get moving. The Heart Stopper, the Rump Roaster, the Bun Toaster, Cake Shaker, and the Baby Maker.
Notorious for naming his dunks, the self-proclaimed Chocolate Thunder became the NBA's answer to Muhammad Ali.
Yeah, Chocolate Thunder flying, glass flying, Rump Roaster, Bun Toaster, Robazine crying, glass steel flying, babies crying, cats crying, Chocolate Thunder's taking them under.
As creative jamming became the rage of the NBA, Gatorade revived the slam dunk contest. And once again, the citizens of Denver were witness to a classic aerial display.
Oh.
NBA's second slam dunk contest would be the Dockers' last.
We are indeed pleased to present the Whirling Dervish from the University of Massachusetts, number 6, captain of the Philadelphia 76ers, Julius the Doctor Irving.
But though the contest began as a tribute to the departing king, it became a battle of potential heirs as rookie sensation Michael Jordan and the human highlight film Dominique Wilkins vied for the slam dunk throne. The torch was passed to Wilkins as he walked away with the title, and Jordan was left to ponder next year's rematch. But the much-anticipated rematch would have to wait. As Dominique counseled his competition on tournament strategy...
Hey, remember what I told y'all, too. Remember what I told y'all, too. Y'all come out strong, right? Serious side.
An injured Michael Jordan could only watch from the sidelines as all eyes focused on a 5'7" hometown long shot.
This committee promised to give the contest everything he has. A native of Dallas, Texas, from the Atlanta Hawks, standing 5'7", Spud Webb.
It was obvious from the outset that there was something unusual in the air. A game of can you top this had begun.
I gotta be kidding.
I gotta do something more nasty now. I gotta go out with something more nasty than that.
But Spud Webb topped them all.
Hey, what I say?
As he turned this contest into a personal fairy tale.
Well, you get down. I'm leaving. You get this one. I'm leaving, man.
A year later, a Jordan Wilkins dunk-off was once again put on hold as Dominique pulled up lame, as did Spud, but both managed to participate in their own ways.
Stan, man, give me something, baby. Give me something, baby. Give me, I'm gonna add. Two hand 360 off the one leg. Guarantee you 50.
With Wilkins and Spud on the sidelines, the contest quickly turned into the Air Jordan Show. With Jordan and Wilkins both healthy, the long-awaited rematch had finally arrived. And Jordan had home court advantage. With more than just the trophy at stake, the game's two most breathtaking showmen would vie for slam dunk supremacy. staging a legendary duel for the ages.
Ladies and gentlemen, truly a trendsetter in the world of fashion, president of the Utah Jazz, Frank Layden. Looking dapper, Frank.
Thank you, Marv. This next portion of the show is something I put together. And frankly, I think it'll make people forget the Albert Achievement Awards. I call it Too Marvelous for Words.
You're just too marvelous, too marvelous for words. Like glorious, glamorous, and that old standby amorous. It's all too wonderful. I'll never find the words that say enough, tell enough. I mean, they just aren't swell enough. You're too much, and just too very, very to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm borrowing a love song from the birds to tell you that you're mine.
Best coach in the history of Utah Jazz?
Tom Nesalkin.
Second best coach in the history of the Utah Jazz?
Butch Van Bredekoff.
Elgin Baylor.
Elgin Baylor, yeah, that is a great coach. Elgin Baylor used to coach the New Orleans Jazz.
Yeah.
Now they're the Utah Jazz.
Right.
All right, yeah. Who used to coach the Utah Jazz? Very, very handsome guy, very famous guy.
Frank somebody?
Frank somebody.
Frank somebody.
He's got round glasses, I know that.
Yes, that's right.
He's,
you're getting close.
He's got a, you know.
You're getting warm.
A little bit of a, you know, heavy set.
Keep it up, that's him, that's him.
Real fun guy.
Yeah, yeah, that's him, that's right.
Mike Ditka, right?
Listen, come here. Seriously, the scar is healing very nicely.
The NBA is making great strides in reaching beyond the borders of the United States and exporting the excitement of basketball around the world. Now, to tip off the international portion of our show, here is an ambassador from the Utah Jazz, Frank Layden.
Not Frank Layden, it's Francois Layden, you ignorant American. Who is this man, Mother Bear, that he can mispronounce my name?
Frank Layden, a man who obviously has lost a sense of reality.
Just rolls the international clips, you fools, you.
And now some quick NBA tips on traveling abroad. First, be sure to sample plenty of exotic foods you won't find at home. Second, take time to spread international goodwill.
America's game is fantastic.
A typical, disgusting display.
Third, speaking a foreign language or two always comes in handy.
Excuse me, senores, do you got habla inglés?
No
habla inglés. Tu hablas inglés?
No
hablas inglés. You answer all my questions, yeah.
Yeah.
Is there anybody here that speaks English? Habla inglés? Habla español?
Sí, un poquito.
A typical, disgusting display.
And finally, if you ever attend a basketball game abroad, do not forget your program.
The little guard, Obradovich. Now quickly to the big guy, and now to the lefty. And he lost the ball, but it picked up in there. Now to the little fella. Oh, boy, I'm having trouble with the name.
NBA action is fantastic.
A typical, disgusting display.
That wraps things up for us, and Frank, I'd like to thank you for providing us with a most entertaining 45 minutes, and you certainly realize that all I said about you was strictly in fun.
Oh, I know that, Marv. You and I are really great friends, and in fact, I was going to suggest that maybe we go out and get a bite to eat after we're done here.
No, Frank, I don't think so. Thanks for joining us. So long, everybody. It just won't work.
Whoops. The sucker play by Barkley, does it work?
Yes!
Abdul-Jabbar starting a new career.